Now to Great Britain, where a disturbing rash of violent crimes involving knives is sweeping the country. A recent survey showed that last year there were about 130,000 violent offenses involving a knife. That's more than 350 a day. And as NBC's Donna Friesen reports, the police and government are scrambling to find solutions.
If the U.S. has a gun culture, the U.K. has developed a knife culture. A surge in stabbings is dominating the news here.
Of knife crime.
The shocking headlines, the flowers, the funerals, the overwhelming grief. Guns, which are tightly controlled in England, are used in just 11% of murders, knives in roughly 66%. And the victims, increasingly, are teenagers. Of the 54 stabbing deaths in London this year, 21 were teens. Sometimes it's gang-related, other times it's petty disagreements that escalate. As in the case of 18-year-old Robert Knox, an actor in the forthcoming Harry Potter movie. This is where he died, outside a bar, after a fight over a cell phone.
They don't realise the value of life. It's sickening.
Though the overall rate of violent crime in England and Wales has dropped, some are calling the rash of knife crimes an epidemic. According to the British Crime Survey, one person is threatened or wounded with a knife, on average, every 4 minutes.
16-year-old Ben Kinsella was attacked while trying to break up a fight. Hundreds took to the streets in protest.
Who are we here for?
Ben!
Why are we here?
No knives!
Their question's simple. Why?
Lord, prepare me.
At church conferences like this one in South London, communities are searching for answers.
Family structure for young people have completely evaporated. We don't have family values. We don't have family discipline.
There's a sense poor, undereducated youth are desperate for power and find it in knives. Britain's Prime Minister has vowed to crack down.
If you have a knife, you will be punished.
Police have more power to stop and search. Still, the stabbings go on. The surge in knife crime now so serious, it's overtaken terrorism as the number one priority of the police in England. Donna Friesen, NBC News, London.